Hi everybody, today we're going to set up an Eco server. Pretty simple process, but there's not a lot of info out there, so I wanted to put a video up for it. You're going to want to go to the website strangeloopgames.com and log in obviously and download the server client. It'll come in a zip file like this. This is the 5.3 version. You're going to want to unzip it into a folder. It can be on your desktop or anywhere you want really, it doesn't matter. When you do that, once you open it up, the main exe is right there, ecoserver.exe. Really simple, all you have to do is run it. First time you do it, it's going to create the world and everything, so it may take a little bit of time. You do need to open a couple ports on your router. Port 3000 is the server connection you need for people to connect to the server. And 3001 is the web client. That's where you do the votes and get other statistics from, so it's important to have them both open. So once you get the server going, it's going to show you some statistics right here like this. If you click on network, you can config. It's going to show you default computer name. That's what this one is. These are all going to be default settings right now. Here it's showing you the game server port and the web server port. So you really just need to, you can change all this by clicking on it and then just deleting it out and filling in whatever you want. So, you know, test server, whatever. And then you want to go to users and configure it. And if you're running a public server, you don't have to mess with whitelisting and everything yet. This is where you would do that though in your admins too. So if you want to do private, you're going to want to change this to true. It's a little drop down over here. And that'll make it a private server. And then you're going to want to whitelist. So you need to add the names of the users right here. So test user, and then if you want to do a second one, go like second user there. And then you just hit OK, and then as long as they have that username, obviously they can log into your server. Pretty simple. That's really it. The server will be up and running. The more you play, the more statistics you have and everything else. It's a pretty nice little interface compared to most that are out there for games. And this is where you can save your storage, and then you can also save the whole server config right here as save as, and then you're good to go. Your server should be running great. Thanks for watching the video, and take care.